for Top That Trade. Joining us today for our trader game, Alan Nuckman, the Chief Market Strategist at St. Paul Research, and Scott Bauer, the CEO of Prosper Trading Academy, filling in for Phil. Away we go, guys, with round number one. Know about order flow. Free commissions offered on trading apps actually could come with a catch if you don't understand how order flow works. Have these so-called free commission trading opportunities changed the market for the better or for the worse?
Free in the fact that most people overtrade now because they don't think and plan their trades like they should because it doesn't cost them anything. It used to be $100 a trade back in 1990 when I started. So that made you plan ahead of time. So, but you got to understand that these wholesalers are actually doing you a favor. You're getting a better bid and offer than the market has. So they're helping you, in a big, big way.
Yeah, I agree with Alan. There's no question that, you know, payment for order flow is definitely a help for the retail trader because you're getting better markets and you're getting more liquidity. You're getting just a tighter market overall, easier to get in and out. So you know, back in the day for a floor trader, when we were trading on the floor, I wouldn't have loved it so much. But for the retail environment right now, it's absolutely a good thing.
That's why we're not on the floor anymore. The markets have gotten too efficient.
Way too efficient.
Round number two, beans in teens. Soybeans have surged 50% in 6 months with front months above $14. Is there more upside in store?
On it. I'd be real careful here. This is a part of a reopening trade. It's also part of an inflation trade with looking at commodity prices just across the board. But what we're seeing is a massive buildup in demand. Well, what's happening now is farmers are looking to take advantage of these prices now, and they're planting crops which actually could result in record harvest. So if that happens, all of a sudden we're going to see a major, major shift from massive demand to possibly oversupply. So I'd watch out for the upside here.
Because the new crop contract, which hasn't actually been planted yet, is a good $2 lower than the current contract now. So I think we talked about beans in the teens months ago, and now that's happened. I like wheat. Wheat has been trading between $4 and $6 for the last 5 years. That target's $8. We're about $6.50 right now. And that's half of where it was in 2008 at $13. So I think from a risk reward, I'm more partial to wheat.
Here's your round number three. Bitcoin blast. That recent run-up above $50,000 in Bitcoin has been a stunner. What does the future hold for the cryptocurrency?
First of all, anything can happen in any market. Never say never. But if you look at things in percentage terms, that's what we do as traders. It's not been that big a gain here this year. It's been about 70%. Way back in the day, in 2010, it went from 3 cents to 30 cents. That's a 10,000% gain. So I think those days are done, but crypto still has a lot more upside. But it's just a matter of how you trade, not what you trade. If you trade some options, I'm not a big believer in low probability out of money options, but you can get some big 1,000% payoffs if you're playing those long shots.
Yeah, and I agree. I think the pricing is a little bit skewed because of the massive dollar amount as opposed to the percentage that we've seen. But with all of the institutional investment that we have seen recently, that probably is going to put somewhat of a floor in not just Bitcoin,
right,
but the entire crypto market for a while here. So I would look
$1 trillion.
Yeah, exactly. I would look for the overall trend to continue to the upside. But as Alan said, anything can happen at any time here, but this is here to stay for sure.
That takes us to the bonus round question for today. Can you name the digital trading exchange that is going for an IPO?
Coinbase, yes.
Coinbase, yes. And they're doing a direct launch, if I'm not mistaken.
Sometimes you make more money providing the shovels and picks for the gold miners than the actual gold itself.
The answer is Coinbase. Great job today. Two winner chicken dinners. Business First AM continues right after this.